Azure Maps is a great service, part of the Azure IoT family, but what you might not know is the power of Azure Maps is not just in the rendering of the maps themselves. And Shish is here to tell us everything about what's really behind Azure Maps as a service. Hi, everyone. You're watching the IoT Show. I'm Olivier, your host. Today, we have Shish from the Azure IoT team. Shish is here to talk to us about Azure Maps. Shish.
Hi. I'm part of the IoT Business Acceleration team, and I really focus on Azure Maps.
So Azure Maps is one of the many services that the Azure IoT team actually builds and develops.
Right.
And very often people are seeing maps for the visual part of it, right? And so they think when we tell them Azure Maps is a new service for building IoT applications and so on, they see the map and what can be done there.
Exactly.
But there's more to it, right?
Yep. And that's the big challenge that I always face when I talk about mapping. The perception is always about that this is how I can render maps and places, but really a lot beyond that. It is about the location of things and what you can do spatially. Like, for example, I want to be able to geofence something, or I want to be able to find out what is nearby a certain area and be able to perform a lot of actions on it. So there is a lot of geospatial actions that is really the core part of Azure Maps, and I'm going to be talking about those in detail as well.
Awesome. Yeah, I like to say that the IoT data that come from devices makes sense in context, right?
Right.
There's a time context,
exactly,
and there's also the location context.
Exactly. And when we're talking about big data, and you have IoT devices really sending out telemetric data, and all that telemetric data doesn't have the location context. Depending on where that data is coming from, it has specific significance, and that's what geospatial data really does. It provides that location context, as you say. Absolutely. Yep.
So we had Ricky several times on the show talking about these some of the features.
Right.
There's a specific scenario you've been working on that you build a sample for, and there's like a little GitHub repo and so on. Let's talk about that scenario that really highlights just what we talked about.
Super. So I spent about 15 years in the retail team in Microsoft before actually working with geospatial.
Okay.
And during that entire time, I actually worked with geospatial and retail. One of the big challenges really working with retail is they're looking at how can they improve the profitability of their physical stores. As you know, retail is really facing a big challenge. Stores are closing. And they're trying to figure out what are the things that influences or disrupts their business in a spatial manner around.
Okay.
And geospatial platforms really enable you to solve that. So in the slide here, what I have is actually a visualization. This is a term that is typically used in retail, catchment areas.
Okay.
Where catchment area in retail really is the area around a store where they generate a lot of their footfall in their business.
Okay.
Typically, it is a 15-minute zone around the store.
Okay.
And what is in that area really impacts the performance of the store in a big way. For example, if there is enough ample parking around the store, it will drive a lot of traffic. If there's public transit within a 2 to 3 minute area, it definitely means better traffic. If there's a competitor right across the street, then it actually disrupts the business. So one of the things that many retailers want to be able to do is be able to analyze the catchment area for retail.
Okay.
And geospatial platforms, Azure Maps in particular, what it can do is it can create a catchment area. It's called an isochrone, where typically with an API called the route range, where I can actually say from a certain point, which is the retail store itself, can I create an area around it? If I walk for 10 minutes in any direction, it creates these points, the furthest points I can walk to.
And like considering the buildings you have to go around and things like that.
Then it connects all those points together, and that's the isochrone.
Okay.
That direction could also be a drive time that I create, 15-minute drive around the store or walk, whatever it is. Once I create the isochrone, the other aspect of what Azure Maps can do as well is really run searches within that isochrone to say, what is in that area? Is there a competitor in there? Is there enough parking in there? Is there a bus stop in there? And I can then score the eyes of Chrome based on how many competitors exist within a certain area around the store, mm-hmm. how many parking spots and bus stops and all of those. And based on that, I could give it a positive or a negative score.
Okay.
And as a result, I could have a rating for that area. So for a retailer, when selecting a location for mm-hmm. a new store, they could look at the score. And also, if they're trying to close down a store, they could look at the scores of multiple stores and say, here's a store that's got multiple competitors around it, doesn't have enough parking. So if you have to close one of the stores, that's probably the best one to do, and so on.
Or build a parking, or
Exactly.
Interestingly, so Azure Maps as a service provides the tools, the APIs to do all of that.
Right.
The data, you mentioned the fact that like a big thing in the scenario you described is to get the information about the competitors and the parkings and so and the transit information. Mm-hmm. So Azure Maps partners with different companies that actually have certain types of data, right?
Right. Yeah, and today we actually get data from TomTom. So a lot of the mapping data itself, like the locations and what businesses exist in certain areas, all of that comes from TomTom, including traffic. If traffic in an area is important, we can actually get information about how bad is the traffic and so on. Yep. In addition to that, we also partner with MoveIt. So MoveIt gives us a lot of the public transit data. Mm-hmm. It gives us ride shares and transit data and all of that. So we know exactly how many routes, bus routes are around there and bus stops and all of those things as well. And also in addition to that, we have the potential of really ingesting data from any data provider. So today, for example, we work with companies that provide human mobility data. So if you look at the chart here, there's a lot of blobs moving around. There's actually human mobility data over the period of a day.
Okay.
And this is information about people moving around. Companies typically gather this information from cell phones. And if you do have that data, we don't. If you do have the data, you can actually upload that to Azure Maps. You can analyze how busy is the area around your store. Does your store get traffic? And if another store gets traffic, or an area around your store gets enough traffic, what you can do is, the other aspect of it is you can start using geofencing.
Mm-hmm.
So geofencing, what it enables you to do is look for areas where there is traffic with the right audience that you want in your store. And you can then geofence that area and then do targeted promotions to those people to actually drive the traffic in.
As in on digital signs and things like that?
Right, exactly, exactly.
On their phones?
Yep, exactly.
Okay.
So it is sort of a fascinating way where they can figure out what's going on geospatially.
Mm-hmm.
They can then drive actions for that to drive traffic. So a lot of retailers are really looking at geospatial platforms to really understand how to improve their business and profitability and all of that using these capabilities.
I love it. That's pretty impressive.
Yep.
Do you want to go to the demo itself and work the demo from there?
Okay. Yeah.
So great, Shish. I see the value of all of that. Now what we want to do is see a demo.
Super. So what I did is I actually put together a demo, and I'm not a seasoned developer. So what I did is I actually used Jupyter Notebooks and the Azure version of it, Azure Notebooks.
Okay.
So what I wanted to do is use a few of the APIs to illustrate what you can do with mapping.
Okay.
And what you'll see here is really that it's not about the maps, but it's about the geospatial capabilities and functions right in there. So this is a demo that walks through some of those capabilities that I talked about for retail. What I did here is I'm trying to analyze a particular address. So in this case, what I did is I was looking for a Starbucks store in downtown Seattle.
Okay.
I wanted to analyze for them, you know, what's the disruptors around them? What's the things that are business drivers around them? So I picked the address here, and Azure Maps has a geocoding service because when I'm using those APIs, it actually looks for latitude and longitude. And what I've done here is I've actually called an API that does the geocoding for me.
Okay, from the address and boom.
Exactly. So when I run this code, what it'll do is it'll actually pass that address over. It'll tell me what the lat long is for that particular address.
Okay.
Once it does that, what I can do now is for that address itself, I want to build an isochrone, and I pass some parameters in here. For mm-hmm. example, I want to do a 600 second zone around it, which is 10 minutes.
Yep.
And I've also set this to be a pedestrian, which is someone walking for 10 minutes from yep. that Starbucks. What okay. can they find around it? Mm-hmm. So to do that, I actually call this service, which does a route range, and it'll actually give me the area around it. It'll mark that area out. I'll run that. Mm-hmm. And when I run this, it'll actually give me back a whole bunch of points. How far can you go if you walk 10 minutes in every possible road that leads up from that Starbucks? Once I do that, the other aspect of what I want to do is I'm extracting all of the polygons from it. And once I extract the data, the other element of what I want to do is really look for what's around that Starbucks. Mm-hmm. So I could look for example, the fast food business has become a disruptor for Starbucks. McDonald's,
yep.
for example,
yep. is starting serving coffee.
Exactly. So I want to know, is there any fast food joints around that Starbucks? So mm-hmm. the key word that I'm looking for here is fast food.
Okay.
I'm doing a geometry search. So this is an API call that I'm using, which will only search within that isochrone
okay.
for everything within that. So here I make that call, and what it does at this point is it'll tell me how many fast food places exist.
Okay.
It's about 11, and I list it out. And you'll notice I have a list right there of
wow.
there's
okay.
11 places
yeah.
right around that.
Yep.
If I were to change that, for example, I go back there and say, these are disruptors, but what about parking? What does that look like? So I could edit the code very interactively. One of the reasons
yeah,
I really
yeah.
like using notebooks is that I could just interactively edit it
yeah,
and then try the code out
yeah,
right from there
yep.
without having to rerun it. And I notice there's 50 parking spots, and I can see all the parking spots right there. So once I do this, I can now upload all of these data points
mm-hmm.
up. I want to visualize it in a map. So that's
okay.
the other aspect
yep,
of what
yep.
Azure Maps really does. So what it's doing at this point is it's passing the data up and generating the map. So
okay.
what I see finally up here is really the tile that was returned. You can also see the isochrone marked in red.
Yep.
And the other aspect of it, you can see in this case, what I did was the parking.
Mm-hmm.
Parking is a positive for the Starbucks. The more parking I have, the more traffic I'm going to get in there.
Yep.
So this was, again, an example of how those APIs mm-hmm. would help those business
yep.
decisions, where a retailer could really understand what's happening around that store,
yep.
Know what's a business disruptor, and be able to score the area as well.
Yep.
So you could enhance this code even more by scoring each one of those things and saying, what's the overall score based on mm-hmm. all of these different factors you have in there?
That's it really impresses me is mm-hmm. that you just call four mm-hmm. APIs?
Exactly.
And actually you end up with something that is
yep.
very useful and that you're in production
right.
and you just had to call simple APIs from Azure Maps.
Exactly.
Love it.
And I'm fascinated by what's possible.
Yeah, we are all fascinated, I'm sure, here
yep.
right now. Let's bring up, we had the slide with links. Let's actually invite people to learn more about Azure
right.
Maps. So this is where you guys should go,
azuremaps.com yep.
Exactly. is the main site.
Yep, so that's where everything about Maps, and including the links to the APIs
yep.
and all of that is available.
Okay.
I actually manage the Twitter handle as well, so
okay.
There's a lot of information that we post through there.
Okay.
We've got a Reddit subreddit
okay.
as well, so you can get information out there. And most importantly, if you want that code,
for that demo.
Yeah, for
yes.
the demo. We've got it on the IoT Tech Community.
Okay, so akrms.com/IoT Tech Community, where we have the code for that demo, but also
yep.
blog post and discussion board for Azure
right.
Maps and other Azure IoT topics.
Exactly.
Awesome.
Super.
Shish, loved it. That's a great
oh.
demo of the value of Azure Maps,
yep.
which is not just the graphics and the rendering.
Exactly.
And I think it was very insightful. I'm sure we're going to see you again soon for other Azure Maps demos.
Super, thank you.
Looking forward to it.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for watching the IoT Show. Hope to see you soon.
Thank you.